Hello and welcome to this video tutorial, brought to you by tastytudes.com. In this tutorial, I will be demonstrating how to lay out placeholder frames in an InDesign composition ready to place in images and text. So here I am in Adobe InDesign, and here is my blank document which I set up in a previous video, and I still have the numbers in each page. If you have not seen this video, the link is in the description under Document Setup in InDesign. Before we begin, I'm just going to delete these numbers as we have no use for them anymore. In InDesign, all elements contained in a composition, such as text, images, and tables, are contained in placeholder frames. To lay out my composition, I will be referencing my SCAMP drawing, which I also created in a previous video. So basically, I'm going to copy this drawing and achieve the same layout here in InDesign. Now, sometimes I might not work from a SCAMP like this. I'll bring in elements individually and move them around and into place. But for this example, I'm going to keep it dead simple and work with my pre-designed layout. Now I'm going to start to draw my frame boxes, and I'm going to do this in normal view. This means I'll be able to see all my marks and guides, which I'll be placing my frames into. I can toggle this view by pressing W on the keyboard. So if I take a quick look at my SCAMP, I'm going to start with the outside spread. The spread featuring the cover page, back page, and inside full page on the far left. Looking at the cover, I can see the image fills the entire page, with a page title at the top left and a logo in the bottom right. So back in InDesign, I'm going to draw a frame box to fit the entire page. Then I'm going to draw another frame in the top left for the text title, and a box in the bottom right for the logo. So if I come over to my toolbar on the far left, I'm going to select the rectangular frame tool. I'm going to start by making a frame to fill the page. Then I'm going to draw a frame on top for the text title, then another frame in the bottom, like so. So a box for my image, a box for my text, and a box for the logo. Great. Now, something important to mention here, and something for you to keep in mind. In InDesign, when you draw a frame box and then draw another frame box, the second frame box will sit on top of the first. And if I draw another frame box, that will sit on top of that. So the most recent frame box you draw will always be the frame at the top. So, as you just observed, I just composed three frame boxes. First, I placed the full frame box, then I placed the top left frame box, and then the bottom frame box to the right. So now I know that the big frame box will be behind the others I created after this. So whatever content I place in the frames on top, created after, will be seen above. Unless, of course, I change the order. For example, let's fill the background frame with a color, and then fill the top left frame with a color. And we can clearly see that the top left frame is sitting on top. Though if I wish to bring the background frame to the top, I only have to select the frame, right click, scroll down to Arrange, and select Bring to Front. Clicking this will now bring the frame to the top, and I cannot see the other frame anymore. Now sometimes you will find yourself with a lot of frames on your composition, and there may be lots of frames on top of each other, and it might prove troublesome to select the frame you want. One technique to keep in mind is the following. So I just brought the background frame to the top. I know there is another frame below. If I move my cursor over it and click, I will click the big frame and not the smaller one. This is because the frame is on top. Now, if I hold down Command or Control for PC and click again, it will select through the frame and look for the next frame below it, like so. So let's say we have five frames on top of each other. I would have to press and hold Command and click five times to get to the bottom one. So keep that in mind. So with the top right frame selected, I will right click, scroll down to Arrange, and this time select Bring to Front, and now the frame is visible again on top. I'm going to select both and remove the colors so I can continue. So back to my SCAMP, I can see that the next page to the cover is the back page. So I want to add an image about a third of the way down, some text to span the width of the page, under this, to the left, some bullet points, and to the right an image, and below this, some footer text and another logo to the right. So back in InDesign, I'm going to use the rectangular frame tool to draw my frames for each part, like so. With another quick look at the scamp, I can see on the next page, I want a big text header on the top and a two-column paragraph text layout under this. So back in InDesign, I'm going to draw a frame spanning across the two columns and another box under this, but this time just in the left side column for now. So that completes the frames on the outside spread. Next, I'm going to take a look at the inside spread. So back to the scamp, and I can see on the far left page, we have a simple grid that will contain some images. So back in InDesign, I will first draw a frame on the top about a third of the way down. Then I can draw another frame under this, down to the bottom of my page, but within the left column guide. Next, I will draw another frame to the right of this, fill in the width of the column like so. Next, I'm going to duplicate this frame. If I press V on the keyboard, this will pull up my selection tool, or I can come over to the menu and select it from there. By pressing and holding Alt on the keyboard, if I click and drag the frame, this will duplicate the frame. I'm going to place this frame immediately beneath the frame above. So now we have two frames. What I want to do next is expand these two frames down so they fill the page nicely. With the selection tool active, I can click and drag over the two frames, and now I have them both selected. Now you can see 8 squares around them both. With these, I can select the bottom middle point, like so, and click and drag. I'm going to drag this down to fill the page. This will expand the two frames down together, so now we have two frames the same size fitting the area we want. But if I look at the scamp, I can see that below the middle frame, I want a further two frames. So back in the composition, I want to select this frame below and make it slimmer. I can do this by first clicking off the two frames that are currently selected to deselect them, then come back to the bottom frame and select it. By clicking on the frame and clicking on the right middle point and dragging it in like so, this will make the frame slimmer. Again, like earlier, I'm going to click on the frame. By pressing Alt, I will drag and duplicate this frame. So now I have two side by side. If I select them both by clicking and dragging over them, again, I can click and drag the right middle point and pull them out, or push in until I have the desired effect. So now we have a rough layout of our grid on this page. Back to the scamp, I can see here in the middle page that we have some text on the top and 3 rows of motorbike images in 2 rows. Back in InDesign, I will use the frame tool to draw a box on the top spanning the entire width of my page within the margin guides like so. Then below this, I will draw a frame box spanning the width of my first column on the left. Then I will press V to pull up my selection tool, click on my frame box and press and hold Alt, and click and drag this to the right to duplicate my frame like so, and I'll position it within the guides of my second column. Now you can see these two frames are not aligned. Well, there's a useful trick. If we use the selection tool to click and drag to select the two frame boxes, with them both selected, I can come up to the control panel on the top, and we can use the align tools here towards the right to help us align the two frames. As you can see, we have a choice, but in this instance, I want to align to the top. So if I press this, my bottom box will snap in line with the top box. Nice. With the two boxes selected, I'm just going to click and drag these to expand the size slightly. Now, with the selection tool, press V and I'm going to hold Alt on the keyboard and click and drag these two frames to duplicate them below, like so. So now I have 4 frames. I want to do this again so I can get 6 frame boxes. So again, pressing and holding Alt and dragging, I can duplicate the frames. So that's the frames for that page. Back to the scamp. I can see on the last page, I want some text on the top on both sides. A table down the left side, and to the right, 2 bike images. So back in InDesign, I'm going to draw a frame box on the top, about so big, again within the width of my margins and guides. Then I will draw another frame under this, staying on the left, all the way down to the bottom. Then on the right, I will draw a frame on the right side, about so big within the margins and guides, and I'll quickly duplicate this by pressing and holding Alt and clicking and dragging like so. I'll place this box just under it. Then with the selection tool, by pressing V, I can select both these frames and drag them down to fit my page. And lastly, I'll draw a text frame in the top right hand corner. So after a little while, I have created a rough layout of my design. At this point, it is not important whether frames are the exact size yet, as we will be making lots of modifications to these as I bring in text and images later. In InDesign, when you place content into frames, such as images and text, upon placing the contents, this actually changes the nature of the frame, which will allow you to apply various effects and alter various properties regarding the contents. At the moment, all these frames are neutral and are ready for elements to be placed inside. So once I'm finished with my frame box layout, it is time for me to move on to the next step. In the next video, I will be introducing the text and a table into my composition, and I'll be demonstrating how we can manage and format this text. So I'll see you in the next video.